Hi, I'm Gaylerd. Welcome back, and I hope you enjoy learning from the lessons and that you're ready to learn even more. Because in this lesson, I'm going to give you the secrets to creating over-the-top strumming patterns that'll put wow factor into your guitar playing. And then I'm going to show you how to use those secrets to your advantage so you can get another step closer to becoming the guitar player other guys want to be. So get your pick, get your guitar, meet me in the studio. I'm going to show you how to create accent strumming patterns. Okay, now before I share the secrets with you, I'm going to strum the guitar in a very bland and boring pattern, the way an average guitar player strums. And I'm only going to use three chords in this exercise because you're going to find it a lot easier to learn accent strumming if you keep your chords to a minimum while you're learning. So for our exercise, we're going to use a very common three chord progression, the D, A, and G progression. Okay? So we're going to do it in 4-4 timing with, let's go eight beats or eight counts to a chord per chord, eight counts per chord. So here's how an average guitar player would play those three progressions. So secret number one is anytime someone gives you a strumming pattern to use in a song, think of it as a suggestion or a recommendation. Don't box yourself in. Think outside the box. Look at that on paper and just, okay, that's a good idea. There's a good starting point. Secret number two is keep your fingers the same distance off the string, okay? Don't let them fly up. Like I see a lot of guys that use their hand and they're holding their fingers, you know, on the palm of their hand like that, and they're strumming it, you know, and they're using the tip of that pick. And by the way, if you haven't watched How to Use a Pick Big Dog Style, you need to get back and watch that lesson. But don't you let your hand get way up off the strings. What I do is I keep my hand right next to I keep my fingers on the finger guard. They're right there, and that's the distance that I'm using. My pinky and my ring finger would be right there on that finger guard, and that's the distance that when I'm strumming chords, those fingers are gliding across my guitar. Most of the time, like when I'm playing chords, I can feel that guitar with those fingers. That way I'm not way up here and I'm not crushing down on the strings either. Don't let your fingers get way up in the air. Secret number three, listen intently to the beat of the song and then strum the mood of the song. Listen to it in your head. Use your freedom of expression to experiment with what you hear in your head and then strum it. Strum it the way you would hear the song if you were, maybe just da-da-da-da, doing that, skipping down a sidewalk while I was smiling on a sunny day. Now, obviously, I'm 64. I'm not going to skip down the sidewalk on a sunny day. But here's what I'm talking about. Think of Old MacDonald. If you were to do da-da-da to Old MacDonald in a boring way, it would be da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Da 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 dum, right? Well, if you were skipping that and you wanted to put some real flavor into it, it'd be something like this. Da 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 da. That's what I'm talking about. That's where your accents come in. Put more to it than just every little beat, okay? So what you want to do is you want to try some different strumming patterns when you're strumming. Maybe you want to start off with strokes. Start off with a hit the bass note of the chord first and then strum it like this. Like that. Maybe you want to do faster strums on it and go loud and soft. Mix in loud and soft strums like this. Use that freedom of expression. Maybe you want to strike the strings individually like that, and then do the chord. change up different beats in it. You could put some slides into those chords. You could do a slide like on that D chord. A lot of times I'll slide on that D like this. There's an A slide. Another thing you can do is you can lift some of the fingers off. Either lift all of the fingers off on a chord. That same thing with an A. Now, another thing you can do is just do some of the fingers, lift some of the fingers, like on a D chord. A lot of times on the D chord, I'll use my index finger and put it on the second fret of the third and the second string, and then I'll lift off my first string and second string fingers, and you'll get a sound like this. On an A, I'll play the A, I'll lift up my pinky. On a G, I'll lift up my two bass fingers. You might want to try some palm muting. Do a combination. Lift up your fingers, do palm muting, maybe strike the strings. There's all kinds of things that you can do. One other thing you can do is don't play all of the strings. Maybe just play a few of the strings in the chord. Now, those are just a few of the unlimited strumming patterns that you can come up with. And I encourage you to just use those three chords and come up with as many different strumming patterns. Have fun with it. You know, use that tempo, that 4-4 tempo of hitting each chord 8 times and come up with different strumming patterns. Now, for your exercise in this one, what I want to do is we're going to play Old MacDonald Had a Farm. And I'm going to do it here in just a minute. We're going to play it I'm going to show you how an average guitar player plays it, and then I'm going to show you a particular strumming pattern that I want you to practice and get down, and then after you get that one down, you can try your own strumming patterns on Old MacDonald. So go ahead, let me show you how to do Old MacDonald Had a Farm. Here's the way an average guitar player would play that.
Old MacDonald had a E-I-E-I-O, and on that farm he had a duck, E-I-E-I-O.
Pretty bland and pretty boring. Now let me show you how to do this with next level guitar type strumming. I think you're really going to like this. This is going to be a lot of fun for you to do. So let me turn the tempo or the metronome on. It's at 100 beats per minute. So when you set your metronome, set it at 100. I'm going to turn it on. There's the beat. Now I'm going to show you. I'm going to play it for you one time, and then I will come back and show you how to do it, okay? This is accent strumming, big dog style, next level guitar style. Goes like this.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O, and on that farm he had a duck, E-I-E-I-O, with a quack quack here and a quack quack there. Here quack, there quack, everywhere quack quack. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O.
And there you go. So here's what you want to do. If you can, I'd like you to try and do a walk up on the fifth and fourth string. Here we go. Open four, two on four, four on four, open four. But when you hit open four, that's where you hit that first D chord for old. Okay, so it'd be like this. Old, okay. Old Mac. And now look at my strumming hand too. It's Old Mac. Old is down, Mac is up. Old Mac Don, just like that. 1, 2, 3, Old Mac Don, no. When I say old, I've got my index finger, I'm taking on that to form that A, right? Because it's quicker, because it's a quick. It's Old Mac Don, Old Mac Don, old hat. So bum bum, bum bum, Old Mac Don, old hat, like that. A farm. Old MacDonald had a farm, had a farm. When I say farm, it's a down on that D. Now remember, rule number one, if you've got something that you'd like to put in there and accent a little better, that's entirely up to you. This is the way I'm doing it. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And that's just up and down, E-I-E-I-O. There's that. Here's that other strum beat that I showed you. Just hit that one note and then a chord. And on this farm he had a duck. E-I-E-I-O. Right? Now here's where it gets fun. With a quack quack here. And that's where you do that slide. With a quack quack here. Quack quack here. See how we're doing that? Quack. You start that slide up. Quack. Quack quack. Down, up, quack, quack, here. So it's 1, 2, 3. Down, up, down. Quack, quack, here. And a quack, quack, there. And now on this one, here a quack, there a quack. See what we're doing? Everywhere a quack, quack. Old MacDonald had a farm. E-I-E-I-O. Now, if you want to have some fun, you just do a little walk. Now, if you want to have that fun, all that is a little run. And those are the notes that we did on those basic runs. Okay, and I'll put the little tab notes up there if you want to try that. So here's what I'd like you to do. Go ahead and try doing those accent strummings. I think you'll have a lot of fun with it. And practice that. Put your own strumming in there. Try a couple of extra things and just get that accent strumming. Play with your heart, not with a chart. Have fun with it, and I'll see you in the next video. Hi, Gaylerd here again. I hope you enjoyed that lesson from my 30-day Next Level Guitar Challenge. If you did, then check out my website at Gaylerd.com. I've got tons of other guitar lessons and classic rock and country song tutorials that'll teach you how to become the guitar player other guys want to be. So if you're ready to start learning how to put wow factor into your acoustic guitar playing, check out the website and get a Hall Pass membership to Gaylerd Guitar. And I'll see you in the videos. Thank you.